color grading in Resolve can be really frustrating and intimidating with all its nodes and the different options you have with them. Especially if you haven't graded before, or maybe you're just used to another program like Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro X. With that being said, let's take a closer look at two very similar looking nodes that have totally different purposes. Of course, I'm talking about the parallel mixer on the one side and the layer mixer on the other side. And the answer to all the question marks that might be in your head when using them can be found in this video. First of all, I'm going to show you the differences between those two nodes, and then secondly, we're jumping into some real-world examples. So first of all, let's spot the differences between the layer mixer and the parallel mixer. As you can see right now, I do have a basic node tree with a white solid, a blue ellipse, and a yellow ellipse fed into a parallel mixer, fed into node number 5, which is the output. So now watch what happens in the parallel mixer. Those two ellipses, they overlap, and the colors where they overlap, they get mixed. So basically what the layer mixer is doing, it mixes or it blends in multiple corrections to one image. Now let's take a look at the layer mixer. So right now I have the exact same node tree. The only difference is that this is not a parallel mixer. This is a layer mixer. I have the exact same blue ellipse and I have the exact same yellow ellipse. Now the way that the layer mixer is working is it overlaps multiple corrections. So basically what the layer mixer is doing is it stacks multiple corrections on top of each other. Now this is a little bit counterintuitive because watch, the yellow ellipse is overlapping the blue ellipse. That means the yellow ellipse is on top. But if we take a look at the node tree, we can see that the yellow ellipse is fed into the bottom input of the layer mixer. So now the way that a layer mixer works is whatever's being fed into the bottom input of the layer mixer is displayed on top. So now let's take a look at some real world examples. Just go forward one clip, and what I've prepared is a basic node tree with a bunch of parallel nodes right here. So in my first node, I did the exposure, in my second node, I did the balancing, and in the last node, I applied a LUT. So now, let's deactivate all of those nodes. So now we have deactivated all of those parallel nodes, and let's start reactivating them one after the other. So on node number 3, I've used a power window to brighten up my subject's face. So if I activate this, look at her skin, it gets a little bit brighter, that's totally enough. And in node number 4, I made a gradient to brighten up the sky in this part of the frame. So let's reactivate this. So node number 5, I made some changes to the skin tones of my subject. So let's activate this and watch on her skin tones. And in node number 6, I made a power window once again, and this just to darken the foreground. So that's pretty noticeable. So now if we take a look at the final image, whatever I'm deactivating will be deactivated. And that's because all of those nodes are being fed equally into this parallel mixer and being mixed to get the final result, where we have this brightened up space, we have the color and the saturation changes, and also the lighting changes on her face, and we also have the darkening of the foreground. Now watch what happens if I would turn this into a layer mixer. To change this to a layer mixer, all you gotta do is click on this parallel mixer, right click, and morph into a layer mixer. What you'll immediately notice is, watch at this part of the frame where we brightened up the scene. So now let's morph this back into a parallel node. So now you can see that this part of the frame is bright. Now if I were to morph this into a layer mixer node, you can see that this part is dark. And that's what I said in the beginning. This one right here is our master mask because it's fed into the bottom. Now take a look at this one right here. It is being brightened up, but it's only brightened up until we hit the edge of this frame, because this one is displayed on top. If I were to disconnect this, and fed this into second input and fed this one, we can still see that this mask is displayed on top and brightens up the scene, but this part of the frame is dark. And that's because this mask right here, Shift H, is affecting this part of the image. And this one right here is affecting this lower part of the image. So if I were to drag this back to its original place, hit Shift H so we can get rid of this, we do see that our master mask that is fed into the bottom is displayed on top. So this brightening up can't brighten up this part right here because this mask is underneath this darkening mask, this one right here. So remember, whenever you want to do multiple corrections to a single image that you want to blend in together, you want to use a parallel mixer. Now let's hop on to the next example. Now this is the exact same image and basically the exact same node tree. I did my exposure on node number 1, I did my balancing on node number 2, and I applied my LUT on the last node. The only difference is that I've used a layer mixer and did other changes to the image. So let's just deactivate those nodes, and this is without all those layer nodes. So this is basically just the exposure, the balancing, and the LUT. Now, if I were to reactivate it from the bottom up, because we said that whatever's being fed into the bottom is displayed on top. So let's start by reactivating node number 5. What I've done on node number 5 is I've used my qualifiers to only select the dark parts of the image. Shift H so you see what I'm talking about. I've only selected the dark parts of the image and darkened them quite a bit more. Now hit Shift H so we can get rid of this magic one. Then reactivate node number 4, and this is basically just a selection of the skin. So watch the skin right here. Nothing else is changing. And hit Shift H. So we can see I've made a qualification right there to my skin tones, but I've also applied a power window, because if I were to deactivate this, you can see that I would have selected the foreground or the field as well. So I activate this power window to just qualify my skin tones and hit Shift H again. Deactivate this one more time. This is before and this is after. I've just made some changes to my skin tones, and this mask is not affecting this qualification because when we do this one, hit Shift H, we can see that I haven't qualified my skin tones at all. Now in this one, I have qualified my skin tones. So even though they are stacking on top of each other, they don't cut out any parts of their previous adjustments. So now let's reactivate node number 3. And what I've done on node number 3 is I haven't qualified anything, because on node number 5, I have my qualification towards the dark parts of the image right there, right on her jacket and the trees behind there. And on node number 4, I have only qualified my skin tones. So node number 3 is basically an outside node of node number 4 and 5 combined. And on node number 3, all I've done was adding some teal to the shadows, add some orange and yellow to the highlights and midtones. But let's say if I were to go totally crazy and would add some violet into my shadows, I would only affect the parts where this qualification and this qualification isn't. So that's basically just an outside node. So now let's reset this and bring this back. So the way that a layer mixer works is it takes multiple qualifications and stacks them on top of each other. Now you would generally use this to isolate specific parts of your image, such as the skin tones, the dark parts, maybe the highlights, or maybe the sky, whatever. Now if I were to morph this into a parallel node, watch what happens to her face. Morph into parallel node, and as you can see now, her face is pretty much washed out, it's pretty much greeny, and also in the dark parts of the image we got a lot of teal, and that's because we've added teal towards the shadows in node number 3, and orange towards the highlights and the midtones. Now in node number 4, I've isolated my skin tones, and in node number 5, I've isolated my dark parts of the image. But because we're using a parallel mixer, those three nodes were treated equally and will be mixed equally in this parallel mixer. So even though I did a pretty good qualification on my skin tones and I've used a vector scope to get them on point, if I were to use a parallel mixer, all of the adjustments that I did in the other nodes will be mixed into this skin qualification, and that's why the skin doesn't look real or good. So generally said, use a parallel mixer when you have multiple corrections fed into one image that you want to blend in together, and use a layer mixer when you want to have qualifications that stack on top of each other without one affecting the other. That's a wrap, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already, to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to more people that might be interested in that specific topic. So yeah, that's all I gotta say. Thank you for watching. Hope you all have a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.